Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series on Renewable Energy Engineering. I am Meeli Trivedi, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in Mechanical Engineering Department. We are studying the chapter of Wind Energy. Okay, so this will be our last chapter and it will contain most of the topics. In this session, we will study about WECS and site selection, etc. Now, let us start our topic named basic component of WECS. Okay, so first the question arises in the mind as what is WECS? Now, so the full form of WECS is Wind Energy Conversion System. WECS. Wind Energy Conversion System. Okay. Now, up to the end of the chapter, you all understand that the wind energy system is converts in kinetic energy of wind into the mechanical energy and finally into the electrical energy. The main component of WECS are wind turbine, gearbox, electrical generator, control system and tower. Now, what is wind turbine? It does a main function, which is to convert kinetic energy into the mechanical energy. Now, gearbox. Since you start learning your engineering, we have studied about the gearbox. Means different types of gears attached with each other and make the motion very smooth and efficient. Okay, it is kept between the wind turbine and electrical generator. It increases the speed of the generator by using the gear ratio and help to produce more electricity. Now, if we talk about the electrical generator, it converts the mechanical energy into the electrical energy. Okay, there are generally DC and AC generators, variable frequency, constant voltage, AC generator and constant frequency, constant voltage, AC generator. So, there are different types. Now, winds are always irregular. So, rotor rotate at different speed, which vary from 0 to maximum. But generator must rotate at constant speed because different speed of rotation will create the electrical constant of variable frequency. It may be generated. Now the purpose of controller to control the effect of the wind speed, wind direction and shaft speed. So we require the controller very well. Now, the system is as automatic orientation system which keeps constant rotor revolution according to the wind direction, okay, and wind speed. Now, whatever the revolution of the rotor, it increases or decreases beyond the certain limit, the generator must be stopped of generating power. It is called the cutoff speed, okay, or we can say it is as a cut out speed. When revolution of rotor are at the desired value, the generator must automatically start generating power. It is called cut in speed. So you can understand that if generator stop generating electricity, it is cut off speed. If generator starts generating the electricity, it is cut in speed. So it is also very important. Now, let us see the pitch control or yaw control system. In this, it automatically changes rotor blade angle and control rotor RPM. I repeat, it automatically changes rotor blade angle. It means blade angle will automatically be changed and control RPM. The blades are provided with the hydraulic pitch control. The pitch angle can be controlled in a wide range, so 0 to 30 degree, to obtain desired power velocity. Now, windmill tower. Now, let us explain the tower. It is very, very important. Generally, in the horizontal axis windmill, the required height of the tower increases with the power rating of wind turbine. Now, different types of tower are used as RCC tower, truss tower, pole tower, galvanized steel tower or galvanized steel structure tower. See, tower is a very important thing in a windmill. because the whole structure is mounted on a tower only, the total weight and load of the system is acted on the tower. So we have to be very specific in making towers. Now, let us understand the electrical protection system. A microprocessor based electrical protection system is used. So we are using the microprocessor system. The protection system include short circuit protection, under voltage, over voltage protection, earth fault protection, lightning protection, etc. So it protects the power supply. In short, it protects the power supply. Now, let us have some classification on WBCS. I think you remember the word WBCS, Wind Energy Conversion System. So it has various parts. So how do we divide it? So we have to classify it first of all according to the position of rotor. So what is the position of rotor? It is the horizontal as well as vertical axis. Okay. Now according to the size of a plant. So small scale, medium scale, large scale. Kind of. Now the third point is as per the types of the output power. So according to the output power, it is DC output and AC output. Now as per the rotation of a speed, so it is constant speed with variable pitch blade, nearly constant speed with a fixed pitch blade, and variable speed with a fixed pitch blade. Now as per the utilization of output power, so how do we utilize it? So battery storage, inner connection with grid, and outer forms of the storage. Now, so these all are the classifications. So you will just have to remember there are basically 5 types in the classification and many more in each classification. I hope you can easily remember this by dividing it in a basic 5 types. Now, let us have some advantages and disadvantages of WECS. Wind Energy Conversion System. So what are the advantages? First advantage is it is the renewable source. It is renewable. Everywhere it is available and we can generate it by using just very small equipments. Now it is non-polluting. It cannot pollute the air. Now next, no fuel requirement. That doesn't need any kind of fuel requirement. Then it can use on a small scale. If we can use on a small scale, it will be cheaper. Okay, now let us have some disadvantages. So because there are advantages, they must have some disadvantages. So wind energy is available in fluctuating nature. It means we have to have some cut in or cut off speed in the power generation. Now it needs storage capacity. Now obviously because it is rotating, uses the kinetic energy, it creates noise. Now high overall weight is high because there is a tower in it. We have to build the structure on the tower, and tower having the lots of weight, so it is having the high overall weight. It requires large area obviously and high maintenance cost. So the cost is also very much higher. Obviously we have to first of all install the object, that's why capital cost is high. Now we have to consider the site selection criteria for the windmills. Okay, because of the larger component require the large space and all, so the site selection is very, very important. Now windmill should be installed at a place where a wind speed is more than 5 km per hour. It should be installed there only. It means it requires the open area also. Now it desire to install windmill at a higher altitude because the winds tends to have higher velocity at higher altitudes. If you remember, we have already studied that up to the 10 meter to 200 meter height, we can calculate the velocity as V is directly proportional to height raised to 1/7. Now icing problem. Blowing dust should not be present at the site as they affect the aeroturbine blades. Windmill should be installed near seashore where the smooth steady wind flows all the time. The land cost should be low. The site selection should be near to the load center. The shack should be near to the road or railway facilities. So by this we can understand that best site for the wind energy system are found offshore and sea coast or at mountains. Okay, now let us study about problems in operating large wind power generator. It must be divided into different parts. There are nearly six different parts. First is location of site. Now what is location of site? It should be big enough, which has a reasonable average high wind velocity. So location of site is very much important, hence we are taking it as a first priority. Now second, constant angular velocity. As we all know, it is must for generating the AC power. If there is not the constant velocity, we will get variable power. Okay, and we cannot have any system which can store the variable power. Hence, it should have the constant angular velocity. Now, third one is the variation in the wind velocity. If there are lots of variation in the wind velocity, the cause of it which will create the fatigue in the blade and blade will break. Now, need of the storage system. It is required, the storage system, to be incorporated along with the windmill. Now, storage supporting structure. So, structure should be the supporting one. Supporting structure have to be designed withstand with high wind velocity. It means if there is more than 50 km per hour speed, it can also generate the power. So, supporting structure should carry the kinetic energy of windmill. Then next, the occupation of a larger area of the land. Large areas become unavailable due to the wind farm. So, the whole area will have to be protected to avoid the accidents. Because generally, we are considering or generating the electrical system. And because it generates the electrical power, it should be consumed. Okay. So, it should be covered with the security. Now, wind farm is a group of wind turbine. Okay, first of all, we have to consider what is the wind farm. So it is a group of wind turbine generator that are all connected together to make electricity that is fed into the power grid. Okay, Tamil Nadu and Gujarat are considered to be the very favorable state because of the very much coastal area, long coastal area. And in Gujarat, we are very fortunate that we are having a very much coastal area, exploiting wind energy sources. Okay, now total estimated wind energy potential in the Gujarat is 5000 megawatt and in the Tamil Nadu, it is 6000 megawatt due to the wind speed. Now, the selected sites in the Gujarat are Veeraval, Okha, Mandvi, Tuna and Lamba, which are producing nearly the total of the wind energy of the Gujarat. If we consider for a day, in Mandvi, it is generating 1.6 megawatt. In Okha, it is 1.1 megawatt plant. Now, in Lamba, it is 10 megawatt plant, but it is right now it is in the processing system. Now in the Mundra it is 3 megawatt and at the Dwarka it is 10 megawatt capacity plants are located there. Now according to the government of Maharashtra, it plays a very important role in developing the source of energy. Okay, there are nearly 5 areas suitable for wind plants. They are Alibag, Ganau, Deoghar, Jalgaon and Mahabaleshwar. Okay, now in the Rajasthan Energy Development Agency, like in Gujarat we have GEDA, in Rajasthan they are RERA. Now here they have identified 5 locations for plotting windmills as Dhamotar and Sawa in Chittorgarh area. Now Jaswantgarh in Udaipur area, Bhagwanpura at in Ajmer and Sepura at Bhilwara. Now, as we all know, wind energy has proved to be an economical renewable source of energy in India. The potential of wind power energy in India is inexhaustible. It has the, it is a country with a fifth, our India is a fifth largest country which produces the wind energy all over the world. Now, the government also launches the various scheme to attract the power generation through the wind energy. Now, if we want to set up the wind power plant, then first we need to find out the place where the siting of the wind power generation. Also, we have to select which type of windmill is used in the generation and also what is the estimating energy at a particular place. Now let us study what are the advantages of wind farm. So wind energy can be easily converted into the electrical energy. It cannot create pollution. Maintenance and operating costs are very less as compared to the other power plant. And nowadays microprocessor and computerized control system are used, so it requires less technical staff. Now let us have some information about types of wind energy system. So there are basically 5 types of wind energy system. So let us have the look on it. Wind energy, wind electrical energy system with direct feed to the main power line, wind turbine generator unit with the battery storage facility, wind turbine generator unit with the diesel generator, solar wind hybrid system, solar electrical energy system with hydrogen storage system. Now wind electrical energy system with the direct feed to the main power line. Let us understand this. It means directly fed to the main line. So whatever the energy is generated, directly fed into the main line. Now main electrical or main electrical supply line. It is used where there are low wind is flowing. Okay. Now second one is wind turbine generator unit with the battery storage facility. Now the battery storage system has to include wind power generator, rectifier, converter and container for the batteries. Where we require all this equipment for the battery storage. Now where there are unfavorable winds, the batteries release the energy to the load. Now third one is the wind turbine generator unit with the diesel generator. Generally it is used at a remote places, and the diesel generator should only be used when the wind energy is absent. When wind energy is absent or machine is under the maintenance, the diesel generator set supplies energy to the grid. So it is generally used in the remote places where we can use both of the system, diesel as well as wind. Now it is the another hybrid system is the solar with the hybrid, solar wind hybrid. It means solar energy and wind energy in the hybrid system, just like the previous one, wind energy and diesel energy in the hybrid one. Now generally located at the tall building and flat open areas. During the day, photovoltaic energy generated means solar energy is generated. Okay, and when there is no sunlight, the wind energy is generated. It is just as simple as we understand. Now wind electrical energy system with the hydrogen storage. So in this windmill, it generates the electrical energy. This energy is used for the electrolysis process to divide the hydrogen and oxygen content. Okay, now in a storage tank. Now the hydrogen can be used as a fuel cell and also in the gas turbine to generate the electrical energy. So students, thank you all of you for watching this video. If you have any query, you can contact me. Thank you.